Easily calculate your Amazon FBA fees with the AMZScout FBA Calculator Chrome extension. The aim of this video is to help you save more money on Amazon once you're going to be finding those products, shipping those products, and I want you to understand your products in order for you to save money, and that means you're going to make more money. So if you're into that, you're liking the idea, please watch the video fully. Now, my name is Vova, I'm an active seller on Amazon, been selling there actively since late 2016. On this channel, you're going to find lots of video guides, tips, hacks, tricks, tutorials, everything is aimed at you to become a better seller on Amazon and understand Amazon FBA better so you can make more money and you can get your own lifestyle and hopefully enjoy life. So if you're into that, please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to get notified if you're coming back. Thank you a lot. I appreciate that a lot. Hope you're enjoying my content, having fun growing. I'm glad to grow with you. And if you're growing with me, I'm really super happy. And let's start the video and don't forget to hit notification bell. So here we have the FBA Calculator free extension. In order to download it, click on the link in the description of this video. It's going to lead you to this page. Simply click add to Chrome. It's going to be on your Chrome in a second. That's an affiliate link, by the way. It means that if you ever purchase anything from AMZScout, I'll get a little commission or cut, so to say, from AMZScout with no extra cost to you. That's a way for you to support my free content here, and I appreciate that a lot. So we have the FBA calculator here, but what are Amazon FBA fees like? For each sale on Amazon, Amazon is going to take a little cut from the sale that you're making. They're going to take a referral fee. Yes, that means for every sale you make on Amazon for X price, they're going to take a referral fee of that price. They're going to take a cut of the revenue, so to say. And also they're going to take a cut in their fulfillment fees because they're taking money. Once you're sending products to them, they have to take them, pick them, put them, pack them. That's called fulfillment fees or pick and pack fees. These fees are also getting deducted from your product, for so to say, from your revenue. And also, they're going to take monthly storage fees from you. And I'm going to explain you everything in a bit. This calculator makes it much easier. So just a few things about the calculator. It's some reviews here, 100,000 plus users here, 305 reviews. FBA calculator for Amazon. There's a little video here by AMZScout. 120 plus people use AMZScout, and you get the following data in just one click. Estimated level of sales and income, full information on Amazon commissions, product size and weight. Decision to make all necessary calculations directly in the plugin window, or need to go to additional pages. FBA calculator will compute Amazon fees using data from Seller Central itself. So it's taking data from Amazon and putting you in front of your eyes, so it makes it easier for you. Use the simplest FBA calculator to compute Amazon income fees without leaving the product page. That's exactly what we're gonna do now. And another thing, there's a little nice blog post by AMZScout called the FBA Fee Calculator or Calculate Amazon Sellers FBA Fees. In this blog post, you can read about Amazon seller fees. What is FBA fees? What is the Amazon FBA calculator? And all this table of contents here, how to reduce fees. Really nice blog post, also going to link in the description for you if you want to go and read it. Do recommend you, especially if you're a beginner, going to be good for you. And let's get into the video's meat, so to say. I'm going to show you how to use the calculator. So once you're on a page of Amazon, you're going to have the calculator obviously installed. Then you click here, Amazon FBA calculator. You just need to get to a product page. And I'll tell you, you're like, wait a minute, how do you get to product pages? How do we find products? Well, that's so you know, this video is part of my Amazon FBA AMZScout playlist where I show you how to use AMZScout for product research. It's going to be linked up here in the card and in the description of this video. There I teach you how to use AMZScout for product research, generally show you AMZScout step by step. Each part of this software, AMZScout, I show you how to use. So if you want to find products, I don't think this is video number 4, by the way, in the playlist. So I'd recommend you watching from the beginning and then everything is going to be understood to you. But for example, we found this product, the kitchen scissors. Yes. And you're like, wait, are they any good? What are they paying? How much can you make with this product? You're like, you're lost. Yes. So let's see. Once you're going to be on the product page, you click on the calculator here, you click run AMZ's calculator, and it's going to have many things here. So what does it have? All the blank fields here. Yes. As you can see here, you can fill them, and you need to fill them with your own data. Yes. Other things that are here, for example, the product weight, product size, date first available, the monthly storage fees, the fulfillment fee, the referral fees are getting pulled out of Amazon automatically. So it saves you the hassle of going and checking out yourself. You have the calculator for this. So what does it take off? So the product weight, obviously the weight of the product, the size of the product. Yes. Easy to understand enough. Date first available, when it was first available on Amazon. And the next thing is monthly storage. How much Amazon takes per item, yes, as storage fees in order to store it in their warehouses per product. That's $0.02, not much. Next is the fulfillment fee. How much Amazon charges per product for each sale made, for the fulfillment fee. Again, that picking, packing, packaging, putting it here, there, taking off here, there. That's the fulfillment fees, $3.48. And the referral fees, $1.94. That's how much they're taking per sale from this product once you're selling. Usually that's 15%. Yes, usually referral fees are around 15%, but it differs. Now, I've prepared a few things here. So for monthly storage, if you want to read in depth into that, I'm going to link in the description below this one, inventory storage fees. That's a page of Amazon itself that you can read in order to understand the inventory storage fees even deeper. Okay, for fulfillment fees, you understand why it's 3.48 and not 5.25 or 1.76. Perfect. So the fulfillment fees will be explained on this page. Also going to be in the description, FBA fulfillment fees for Amazon.com orders. There you can determine exactly and how and why it's placed in the 3.48 category. And the last one is referral fees. It's $1.94. So I have the third link is also going to be the selling Amazon fee schedule. And here you have the different categories with different referral fees. Yes. And everything is going to be explained there. So this will close all the gap here for you. It's down in the description along with all the other stuff. Enjoy. But now let's see how the calculator works. So for example, this product was pulled from Amazon. It's $12.95. But let's make it easier with 10. We're going to round it up. And estimated monthly sales is going to be 100. Yes. Down here, with the lower side, you're going to have total FBA fees. Yes. How much Amazon takes total per each sale. And that's simply by adding the monthly storage fees to fulfillment fees to referral fees. And 1.50 plus 3.48 plus 0.02 equals $5. And that's exactly what Amazon is taking each sale that you're making. So if you sold this product for $10, say, automatically $5 are going to Amazon. Next is you have the rest to play with yourself. But what do we have left? We have profit per unit. Yes, net margin, return on investment, and estimated monthly profit. Now, that's in case we're sourcing this product for $0, then we're gonna make pure $5 per sale, but we're not. Yes, we need to pay for our products. So that's why we have here product cost, shipping costs, CPC costs, that's like advertising costs, and taxes. So let's go one by one. Let's say we source this product for $0.7. So let's say, yes, these scissors cost us $0.7 to create, to pack, and essentially to get them out of the factory gates for $0.7. That means creating the scissors, packing them into boxes, maybe adding a logo here, as you can see. Yes, there's a logo, adding an insert, everything together. That's product cost is going to be $0.7. Yes. Next is we have shipping cost. How much would it cost for us to get the product from the gates of the factory to Amazon warehouse? How much is it? How much is it for all the shipping, including everything on the way? Let's say per item, it's $0.3. Yes. And 0.3 plus 0.7 makes it $1 landed cost. What is landed cost? Landed cost means how much it is to get the product from the factory to Amazon. That's $1 for the shipping, for the creation of the item, everything together, $1. Okay. That's hopefully it's understood by here. Next is CPC cost, how much we're going to spend on advertising. But let's leave it blank, and here's the taxes. Let's leave it blank as well. We're going to fill it in a second. But with this scenario, when the product costs us $1, it's selling for $10, and the fees with this specific product size, with this specific product weight, are $3.48, yes? And of course, the referral fee is 15% in this specific category, that's $1.5. The monthly storage also is based on the product size, is 0.02. So $5 are taken by Amazon as fees, and a product costs us $1. So if we're selling for $10, how much is left? $4 per unit, yes. $4 profit per unit. Net margin there will be 40%, if so, yes. The return on investment, the ROI here, yes, it's gonna be 400%. And estimated monthly profit then, yes, is gonna be $400 with this scenario. And that's a good scenario because ROI of 400% is very high ROI. It will allow you to quickly get in more products, yes, because you're that fast, so to say, you're that fast profiting a lot. You can buy therefore more inventory and ship in more inventory, which will make it even more, and you're going to get the ball rolling. Realistically, to get a 400% ROI product is higher than Amazon. Why? Because look, we still didn't put any CPC costs, any cost for advertising, no taxes at all. So let's make it more realistic. Let's say that in order to get those 100 sales, we're going to invest $100 in PPC. Look at that, how the numbers change. We've invested now $100 in CPC, in those advertising costs, and straight away our ROI dropped down to 150%. And why? Because we have now spent more money onto acquiring the product, and it's much, the estimated monthly profit is now $300. It fell down by $100 because we invested $100 into the product. And next part is the taxes. Now, let me tell you that the taxes, at least how AmazonScout calculates them, they calculate the taxes based on the revenue. So let me explain. Let's say the taxes percent is 10%. Look, for now, we have 0% in taxes, but our estimated monthly profit is $300, yes? We had 10% tax, and somehow our estimated monthly profit dropped to 200. You're like, wait, 10% taxes added, and we are paying $100 less? Well, from what I understood is taxes by AMZScout are calculated based on the revenue. So let me explain it to you in a second. Let's get back to zero. Now, before I get into that, I'm going to tell you that you need to ask your own accountant or understand what are the taxes situation in your country, in your specific case, because, you know, it might be different. It might be. It is different for each person in each country. So understand where you're coming from and obviously act accordingly, yes? But let's say you have 10% in taxes. That's the taxes you're gonna pay. After what you've understood, you're paying 10% in taxes. And why is it dropping that much? It's taking it from the revenue. Let me quickly calculator here. Let's find a calculator and let me show you what's going on. Oh, no, this one. So taxes, we have 10% in tax, yes? But 10% are getting taxed on the revenue. So let's say we had $10 was the product sale cost. Yes, we're selling our product in $10. That's the price. We have $100. Yes, it was 100 units sold per month. So that's $1,000 in revenue we're making. Now the tax are going to be deducted from this number, from the revenue. That's at least the way AmazonScout does it. That's how I learned to use the calculator there. So if we're paying 10% in tax, 10% out of 1,000 is 100, yes? So from the 1,000, we're gonna remove 100 because it goes to taxes. You understand? And therefore, it's $900 now. From the $900, oh, wait, where's that? I'm always taking you to the last part of the video. From the $100, we're gonna also remove the product cost, which is $100. Yes, it costs us to produce the product. Yes, that's already leaving us at $800 profit. We're gonna remove the fees of Amazon, $500. Yes, that's left with $300. And we're also gonna remove $100 in, what was that? The PPC, right? The last part, what CPC costs. We paid $100 for advertising. We paid 10% in tax, and we paid all the money to Amazon itself. So $500 we paid to Amazon again, $100 we paid in taxes, and we paid $100 in PPC, and $100 was spent on the product. That left us with $200 profit, yes? And that's 100% return on investment, which is a great number to be at realistically on Amazon if you can have ROI of 100. If you want to read more about ROI, it's going to be in this blog post that I mentioned before. It's going to be in the table of contents there. I think it's going to be somewhere in the in the lower part of the article. I don't exactly remember, somewhere here, it's gonna be somewhere down here, the ROI cost, the ROI, so to say, calculations, just because I'm not gonna do it now. Let's go back to the video. So that's the way to use the calculator. This way you can understand how much you can make per month, how much the product takes per month, and let's say that the product, we're selling this scissors for $15. You see the picture changes a lot. So see, for $10 of, if we're selling in $10, our estimated monthly profit is $200. But if we're selling even in $11, we're already profiting $75 more just by adding $1 to the product price. That's a very good place to be at, right? Of course, you want to always sell the product for more and more. And that's about it. Now, let me tell you one thing more about AMZScout, that if you want to ever invest in AMZScout, although this one is completely free, the calculator, you have this nice package that AMZScout prepared for you. You can get it through the link in the description. It's a special link that will have this promotion applied to your purchase. And what you can get here is AMZScout Extension Pro. That's the Chrome extension, We've talked about it in the previous videos in the playlist. That's why I recommend you watching the playlist as well. You get in the web app, and these are going to be very crucial for your product research if you want to use AMZScout for a product research. Keyword tracker, that's something that detracts your keyword positions by AMZScout. Quick view is also a nice extension. That was the previous video, by the way, in this playlist, that can also give you a bit more things once you're browsing products on Amazon to see more information about them. FBA calculator here is what was just spoken about. AMZ stock stats is going to be also one of the videos in this playlist. We still don't have a video about this, and eBay price comparator. So usually it costs $506, but with the discount in this bundle, they take 278%, not percent, dollars out of it. I think that's like 55% or more. And you get all this bundle for $228. Now, I really don't recommend you buying it right now, because I recommend you watching other videos, understanding what can you buy here. Yes, but just so you know, there is this deal. It's again linked in the description. Check it out and you're gonna understand. It's more than 55% saved, and I would say that $228, that's one you pay it once per year, and that's about $20 per month to get all the package for product research. That's pretty good deal. And again, you can see how all these work in the playlist that I shared with you. And if you want to see the playlist, by the way, it's going to appear here on the screen. Click on it now if you want to see other videos on this playlist to understand how AMZScout works. I really appreciate you watching this video. Hopefully everything was understood. If not, just drop comments and let me know. And I'm going to see you in my next video here or any other video. Thank you a lot. I'm going to see you in my next one.